What's up, everybody, and welcome back to episode 6 of Toilet Princess. We were here getting the power up or something, right?
Yeah, we got the shield bash.
Oh, right, yeah, the shield bash. That's right. Yeah. Yeah, now we have to go back out into the world. Right? We're going.
Yeah, we can use Baby Oko.
Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah.
Stop.
It's been a couple days.
Now to talk to the gross baby.
The baby's much better looking than the mom.
Wanna go back to my mama? Yes.
Do you remember the mom's voice?
It's an old lady voice.
No.
It's your shitty voice. No.
It's Minnie Mouse.
Ugh. I'm gonna avoid using the Oko.
Well, welcome back. Without further ado, we're off.
I think I do a pretty good Minnie Mouse voice.
I think that it's a great Minnie Mouse. I honestly do think it's a great Minnie Mouse. I just hate the sound of Minnie Mouse.
Well, it's a good thing I'm not doing Miss Piggy for her.
Yeah.
Dwight doesn't like Miss Piggy.
I don't like any high-pitched girl voice. It's just, it's like ear-piercing to me.
Miss Piggy's voice isn't high-pitched, though.
It is. Are you kidding me?
It's not Minnie Mouse high-pitched.
Miss Piggy?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no.
Miss Piggy, yeah.
But still.
We want to go out that door right there, by the way.
Well, I'm collecting money.
Okay, I just want to make sure. But yeah, no. Miss Piggy's like, ooh, Kermit.
Oh, right, yeah. She has like that weird cadence.
Yeah.
I like everything Miss starts Piggy. High and then it immediately dips down.
Oh, okay, angry boots. See, that just puts him out for a second.
Oh, wait, I need to change my thingy anyways.
Yeah, get rid of Oko.
Oh.
Don't worry about it.
I didn't pick out any pellets.
Yeah. So we left Epona by that bridge.
Yeah.
She's going to be there until the next time we call her. Like, she just stays there. She won't go anywhere else.
Yeah, no, she's hanging out. Left her, I guess, in the...
We won't need her for a while, though. She's right by our house.
I get the bow soon, right?
Yeah, we get the bow in this dungeon. Just, you can poke him with your sword when you walk up to him.
Oh, right, because I can walk here.
Yeah, just forward B, and you, like, poke him.
Yeah.
See? Poke him. Give me a little poke in the butt.
You gotta lock on for the poke, though.
Yeah. I love the angry boots. Don't!
Did that on purpose.
Now you gotta go back.
Oh, what?
Yeah. We need to be up there. Man, you suck.
Man, it's not the first time.
It's not gonna be the last time in here.
No, God, no. I do not claim to be proficient at this game. God, it's weird that you still have to hold down to go forward.
Yeah, if you stop moving, then it'll recenter.
I tried that just then.
Yeah.
I tried stopping to move it the other way, but maybe I was too quick.
Hey, dude. Ooh. I love the Goron music.
Yeah, it's fun music. Just, you know, bear with me, everybody, with these ladders.
The ladders are the worst thing in this game. They seriously are terrible.
Well, Leanne and I were talking about why I feel like some of my movements may not be as fluid as I would hope to be in a game where I feel like I should be able to control pretty well. Because there's a huge delay from when you turn to when you actually turn. I don't know if you guys will be able to hear it, but like, here's me turning to the right. Like, that's a huge delay.
It's like, yeah, it like it takes a while to like start up.
Yeah.
Just poke him in the butt.
Just poke him anywhere. What happens if I let go of him there? Okay.
Yeah, you just fall down. There will be some places where, like, you can jump off of something and put on your boots in midair and then get sucked to a wall. It's pretty cool.
Okay. I'm gonna make a guesstimate here and say I gotta do something like that. I'll just pick up multiple.
I wish you could stack those. That'd be cool.
Oh, okay.
See, that's one thing I don't understand why they didn't fix it in this game, is there will be things, like, later on in this dungeon, there's big magnets that suck you from the ground up and then swing you around, and in those, your hat will actually point down, because you're upside down,
oh,
but
yeah,
here it doesn't,
right.
And I don't know why they didn't fix that in this version. Like, it must
have
been...
That's strange. Yeah.
Also, you can look at the map to see where we need to go, because that's actually a map of the ceiling right now.
Okay. So I need to go towards that thing?
Yeah.
That exit over there?
Yeah.
So I need to go around this way.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure there's a chest with some rupees around on the other side, near the door there.
The ceiling?
Yeah. Well, I mean, you drop down to a little, like, ledge.
Oh.
But, yeah, with the Angry Boots, they take so long to get around. To me, it's not worth it.
Yeah.
It's either rupees or one of the stupid stamps.
You don't really use rupees for a whole lot of stuff in Zelda games.
Yeah, and in this game, we meet a lovely girl by the name of Agatha. Oh, no, the other way. Yeah. We meet a lovely girl named Agatha, who I don't think is in any of the other Zelda games, but she collects bugs. And so when we bring her bugs, she'll give us like 100 or 50 rupees for every bug we bring her. So then it's really easy. And there's 24 bugs.
One of those weird bug girls.
Yeah. Like, she's the princess of bugs, and she invites him to her tea party. We'll princess meet her fairly soon.
What happens if I let go on top of the fire?
You'll probably just fall next to it, but you might fall all the way down and have to go back around again.
I don't want
to
do that. Yeah. It takes too long.
It takes way too long.
Hip.
But yeah, no, eventually we'll find uses for our money, and then we won't need money ever again because we'll have Agatha.
Now, this is the game that has that super expensive outfit, right? That doesn't do anything for you?
No, it makes you, invulnerable? You can't get hurt at all when you're wearing it, but only as long as you have money.
So you lose money when you get hit?
Yeah, well, your money, like, if you have 999 rupees, it'll go down, like, every second you lose, like, 2 rupees or something. Like, it's pretty quick. But then when you get hit, you lose, like, 50 or 100 rupees at once. Finish move.
I tried it. I was pressing B when it said
to press A. You press A. God, you're so stupid. You need 2 feet on the button.
Nah, I'm good. I wanted to double check to make sure I wasn't missing anything.
No, you're good. I love the way he puts on those boots. He just jumps into them and jumps out of them. Mm-hmm. I wish I could put my shoes on that fast.
Well, if your shoes were made completely out of metal and could
Yeah, he
stand.
Could probably jump out of them pretty quickly. But look, he must have, like, massively muscled legs that we just can't see under those pants for him to be able to walk around upside down with those boots on. See here? His hat points down.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
I don't know why they couldn't have fixed that.
That's a cool mechanic. I like that.
The magnets?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is one of my favorite dungeons.
Oh, okay.
That bat was a little more important than the moblin.
What am I looking at?
I don't know. Turn the camera. Maybe you can see.
Nothing. I'm looking at a wall.
That's a nice wall.
Like, look at the textures on that wall. That's a sweet wall. Man, something is just super interesting over there.
I think it's just that big crane. It's just like,
maybe
whoa.
He's just really into machinery.
Well, he does live in this super tiny village where everyone lives in trees. So there probably aren't that many machines where he's from.
Man, his ability to swing while running in this game is so underrated.
Yeah. That's one of the things with the Wii version. You actually have to swing the remote. I think there's a setting there you can change it so it's just the button. Tech tights. See, I'll be honest, I did not know the names of most of these bad guys till the grumps were playing all the Zelda games. Because they mention all the names of the bad guys, and I'm like, oh, okay, so the spider water things are tech tights.
Yeah, I actually didn't know that the what the bats were called.
Yeah.
Until they were playing, I think, the first one?
I think it was the first one, because that's Danny where they mentioned the Tektites, and they mentioned the names of the little guys who shoot out the seeds at you. But yeah. I don't remember what those are.
Jump.
No, that ledge is too big. He can only go up tiny ledges.
He's a little boy.
He is tiny. I mean, like, when he stands next to other, like, adults in this game, he's, like, a good head or more shorter than everyone else.
All right. We got puzzle here.
Yeah, we got crystal. Puzzle.
I got a gate I probably have to go under.
Probably.
Yeah. I don't know. There's a rock block on the way? I don't know if I can push that or not. Let's see. Get on it.
You could just go around it. You're supposed to push it out of the way, but yeah, you could just go around it.
What's the point then?
Well, it's so that you go under the water, I guess.
But I just climbed over it. Whatever.
Angry boots. The angriest boots.
Oh, nailed it.
Yeah, I love that kind of stuff.
It'd be great if, like, you can get an upgrade for the Angry Boots where it puts, like, little rockets on the heels so you walk faster.
Yeah. Because
that would be...
That's one thing, because they sped up his climbing. I'm surprised they didn't speed up his walking with the Angry Boots.
Wow, that magnet, it goes a long way.
Yeah, these are pretty powerful magnets, which, again, is surprising that he's able to walk on these magnetic walls at all.
Watch this sweet trick.
Nice.
Even though that's what you were supposed to do.
It's exactly what you're supposed to do.
Yeah. They made it pretty obvious what their little cutscene.
Yeah. They give you like a little platform for it and everything.
Yeah, especially when you're walking sideways like that. That's like the strength that those people would need to, like, you know, when they're grabbing onto a pole sideways.
Yeah.
And they make themselves straight out. Like how much core strength you need for that stuff.
Or have you ever seen like the...
I gotta hit
the
this?
Yeah. The crazy, like, strong, like, pole dancers who do the whole, like, walking on air thing really slowly. Yeah. Like, it's like, those people are cool.
Yeah. Ow.
Your B attack is a lot better when you're a person.
When you're a person.
When you're a person, your B attack is way better than your other attack.
Sure. Those things got an upgrade.
Yeah, those are terrifying.
So, I had to get up on the wall.
I don't like those things.
Yeah, no, I never liked them in Link to the Past either.
Yeah.
I gotta...
There's either rupees or a compass to the left there.
Can I? That's all I can do with the camera.
If you push in on the others, there you go.
That's not disorienting.
Yeah.
Hey, could you imagine doing this, what he's doing right now with his head?
Just like spinning,
that's
standing
me real
on
sick.
The
I'm sorry, everybody.
It's starting to make me dizzy.
Yeah, oh god, that was bad.
Yay!
Oh, hell yeah, piece of art.
We just need two more.
Totally worth it. Try to jump up on the wall.
Remember, this isn't Breath of the Wild. Gosh, could you imagine how painful that would be? He was just on his butt, and then he was standing up. He'd, like, break his ankles.
Oh, yeah. Now, his legs would be broken. This is by far the most unrealistic part of this game.
But isn't it the best?
No.
His angry boots. It's, stomp.
It's kind of annoying, honestly.
You don't like the angry boots.
Just because they're slow.
Yeah, they
That's all. That's the only reason. It's like, I don't like anything that makes me slow for... I mean, it's a good reason, I guess. They're fucking giant metal boots, but...
They're trying to make it as realistic as they could. They're like, well, you know, no normal guy would be able to walk on this wall, but he'd be slow if he did.
I guess.
See, why didn't... So the whole boot's iron. They could have just, like, put a little, like, iron sole on the bottom of your regular boots...
You would probably need the rigidity and probably the weight for when you're, like, trying to stay, like, from the wind blowing you off and stuff.
Yeah.
Because I was thinking that, too.
So do you remember at all, you probably don't, when this game came out, there was a shooting gallery Zelda game that came out shortly after.
Yeah.
We had that game, and it came with like the Wii Zapper, which is like this gun-shaped thing that you just stick the Wiimote inside of.
Yeah.
And there was it was based off of things like this room that we're in, where it was just like you can just snipe everything around you. But that ability to just like snipe things in this game always made me laugh. That game was pretty fun though. We had it. Mm-hmm. It was kind of monotonous, but with the Wii Zapper, it was pretty easy. Like it set you up so you could do it really well.
Tried to trick me. Ain't gonna trick me. I'm too fast for you. Aw, come on.
You're too slow, loser. Watch out for the Tektites.
Before you get tetanus.
I did not know there was a ladder there.
Wow.
I've always walked all the way around the room.
Now who's the loser?
Me. See, his hat should go upside down. They obviously had the ability to do that.
Did you see it actually change directions when it started going sideways?
Yeah.
It started leaning, so.
But then it's just like,
there
nope.
There is physics there.
Yeah.
Just only left and right.
Hey, another old guy.
Yeah.
So we had Cordon Bleu. I don't remember the other one's name.
It was Cordon Purple.
Oh yeah, Cordon Purple. Oh yeah, they all say Bretta.
Yeah, they're all Hawaiian.
Bretta.
We need Brando to come voice all these. Make it. I'm one of the four elders of the Goron tribe. I'm called Gor Ibizo.
Ibizo.
Ibizo. Isn't that food?
I don't know. That's a very familiar name. Let's see.
You've heard of the plight of our patriarch. Otherwise, you have not come to see me. Here, take this, brother. You got a key shard.
Dun,
hell
dun,
yeah.
Dun, dun, dun.
Is that the noise he just made?
There's a guy named Ichikawa Ibizo, who's a actor who is...
Did he act in any Nintendo films?
I don't know. But then there's a Naruto character named Ibizo.
That's who I'm thinking of.
Yeah. What's that guy's face?
There's one more shard, but seeing as you remind me of the dangers that lie in the path to it, there's something that may help you. A weapon said to have been left in this mine by a hero of old. It is beyond price.
Yep, they look the same,
totally,
don't they?
Yeah. Looks just like him.
Yeah.
The dude from Naruto. It is beyond price, and so we have protected it through generations. Now, when our tribe balances on the brink of ruin, it could aid our salvation. The hero's weapon is stored safely up ahead. Talk to the guard and take it with you, with the blessing of the Gorons. Thanks, bro.
Yeah, he's pretty cool. I like Ibizo. Even if he is a Naruto character / some sort of actor.
I probably should collect some rubies. I can't do anything in here.
Well, we bought that shield, which was 200. So we don't really need money anytime
soon.
Stop
doing that.
Just walk slowly. Tilt slowly.
No, I'm looking at that LeBrock thing. But...
Yeah, there was a red one in the other room. I don't remember what was in the first room.
It just looks like something I'm supposed to damage.
I know. It's like you want to like claw shot it and take the jewel out or something.
Yeah. Does this game have the double claw shots?
Yes. Those are fun. That's in my game. I'm at the place where you get them. And you literally just like claw shot from one wall to the next, which is kind of cool, but it's also really terrible. Stomp, 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 stomp.
Yeah,
stomp,
I just.
Stomp.
I...
You could drop from here, I think.
Can you?
Yeah. There's a chest.
I want to know why it goes all the way around.
Well, for people who really like listening to the angry boot stomp. A chest.
Is this dungeon just based around them because you got them like near here? Do all dungeons have that stuff? Because
no, not all dungeons have the stompy boots. Okay. Although we will use them when we get to the water temple a bit for swimming and stuff. Yeah.
That makes sense.
I think from here on out, we mostly only use it when we're swimming. Like, after this dungeon. Okay.
I just didn't know if it was going to be, like, a core part of the game or not.
No.
Hey, look, a boss.
No, this is the guard. We have to talk to him.
Bullshit, there's an arena in front of me.
No, Ibizo told us to talk to him.
What business does a human have coming here? No business.
I like his little, metal hands.
That he's going to bash my face in.
Yeah. This is a forbidden place.
I will protect this treasure from you. I just broke all the things, man.
Why wouldn't they
build those to be
stronger? To not suffer from a weight limit? Full faith that you'll figure out how to fight this guy.
Yeah? What are these things?
Don't fall. We remember what happens when you fall in the lava.
Yeah. Come real close to the edge, buddy.
Brudda. You know, he could also be like, have a New Jersey accent. I can't do a New Jersey accent.
How is he staying on here?
With that little shimmy sham he's doing with his feet. See the little tap dancey move? Did he just punch the ground? That's what it sounded like.
Yeah.
I like his tummy jiggles. Look at his tummy when you do that. Boop, boop.
Alright. I'm gonna do something with the heavy boots here.
This is a two-part fight, so.
So I gotta hit him when he's winding up.
Poke his tummy.
Oh, okay. So I gotta throw him. Oh, I wasn't paying attention.
See, but you know what to do now. Poke his tummy. And then get out of there. Watch out, you only have 2 hearts.
No, 1.5. Learn to count.
I can count. Now take off your boots and get out of there.
He's telling me I can grab, though.
Yeah, but you can't grab till he runs at you.
My boots don't come off quick enough.
Yes, they do.
No, for that move.
Now put on your boots so you can grab him.
Okay. Whatever. I need to start over anyways.
2 hours later.
Uh-oh.
God damn it!
Go grab some hearts before you jump down there. Don't jump down!
No, I'm fine.
Yay.
I need that quarter of a heart.
Oh, yeah, you do.
Come on. Come at me. Bang!
That's what he's saying. He's like, come at me, bro. Come at me, brudda.
Put the sword away. Oh! Oh, fuck! Come back to the center, buddy. Actually, no. You stay there.
Run, 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 run!
Oh, come on, man!
Because he only rolls three times, that was the last time. Die already, you stupid guard! No one likes you.
Bang.
Oh, thank goodness he went off the edge.
Okay, I was about to ask, it's like, does he have to go in the lava?
Yeah, he does. And you can throw him and then he just gets back up, and that sucks. See, now you got the science of this down, though.
Don't say things like that. What's wrong with you?
It's because I believe in you.
I'm not done with this fight.
But yeah. You got it down, obviously.
Hey.
The heck, this is four times? I thought this was only twice.
Well, I died, remember?
Yeah. Man, you were just like right up in that belly. Aw, oh, man.
Nope.
Come on, give us a break.
Give me your belly.
Give me your belly.
Damn it.
Dang. You might have no, he's just avoid him. He's gonna push right out of it. Oh, he didn't. Yay! Yay!
Alright. So I'm just going to cut out all my previous attempts and then just do that one.
What previous attempts? Yeah. This was your first try, yeah. Obviously.
I heard a lot. I knew that humans were capable of such feats of strength.
After dying a couple times, yeah.
Yeah, after you killed me a couple times.
Are you going to see the patriarch? Maybe you're not a terrible guy that I've been throwing in lava or something.
Even though you kicked my ass, maybe you're a cool guy.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you want the hero weapon. Oh, that's cool.
But in exchange, you must save the patriarch of our tribe.
Because now he's making the rules.
Right. Oh, great. The lava's coming up.
Yeah.
Perfect timing for us to put these chains back up.
Yeah, no. He's got a button that just lets the lava in and out.
They chopped a giant rock magnet, and then they hung it up.
Yeah.
Bye, buddy.
I love the way he shuffles to turn around to look at you. It's like, oh, my tummy hurts.
Yeah, my tummy would hurt too if I got dropped in lava three times.
Yeah. And poked.
That's a bunch.
That's specifically what I meant.
Well, I mean...
You got him with the pointy end.
I didn't roll into it and bash my head.
Da-na-na-na!
Finally, the bow! Oh, but I gotta collect arrows, don't I?
Yeah.
Targets and stuff. When's he gonna get a bow that has infinite ammo?
Never.
Damn. Okay. I'm in my head, I was trying to think of, like, do I want it on that button or not? Let me guess, I gotta shoot something?
Maybe. Oh my god.
I figured it out.
Oh.
Ow, asshole.
Yeah, those guys like to hang out on the ceiling. Hey, look, it's our friends.
Yeah, it's a lot of them. All right, so, let me see.
You can only shoot them when their eyes are red.
Yeah, I'm just looking around the room with an arrow.
The nice thing about the spinny tower demon laser shooty dudes is that, and that's their official name, is that once you kill them in this game, they stay dead.
Okay, I can't pull them. Or can I? Nope. I gotta activate something, huh? Activate this one. Nope.
They're all going for you.
This is fine.
Yeah. I like to imagine just throwing up lava at you.
Boop, 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 boop.
So now we can move them.
Okay. This is swinging nothing. I was practicing.
Well, he gave you a heart. Now you have full hearts.
There we go. Truth be told, you can't move me until I lose my eye, too.
Yeah.
Then I'm on
Once
the ground,
my eyes are gone and I'm dead, then I'm it's done. Like, yeah, move me wherever you want. I give up.
Yeah. Hell yeah, money.
Bling.
There's a door and a whole bunch of other crap in that one. Boop, boop, boop. Wait, what about this one? There's another door.
Yeah, there is.
This door goes back. This one is just one room. Let's go to that one. Excuse me.
excuse me. I need to get past you.
Hey! Hey, cool, another old man. What up, buddy?
Oh, so he's friends with Cordon Purple.
Huh. Here you are at last. I hear you might pay a visit, young man.
From who?
I am farsighted in all things.
Oh, from his eyes.
Yeah. He's got like nipple tassels on or something.
Yeah, what are those things called?
Pasties?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's wearing pasties.
Here you go. The last key shard.
I like the
Combine
like
all three shards.
The half cool sun thing he has painted on his tummy.
He collected all three key shards. Alright. Yeah, he has a very sunny tummy.
He has a sunny tummy.
That's his name, Sunny Tummy. Sunny Tummy.
So we have Cordon Purple.
Mm-hmm. We didn't give a name to the last guy.
It
was Naruto.
Old
man Naruto.
But then there was the second one we didn't name either. The first guy we met in here who gave us the first shard.
Oh, yeah.
I don't remember what he looked like.
He's just super tiny.
Yeah.
Who knows how powerful the bus is in his new grotesque form.
Is he the cat bus?
He's that bus.
Dead bus. I wouldn't want to fight the cat bus.
Mm-mm. But I suppose I trust your power, considering you came this far. Hurry now to the Patriarch's room. Thank you. What do you have in your chest, buddy? Well, there's another one with crystals. This one's purple.
I like... The guy's got those alligator skins up on the wall.
I got 50 ruples.
50 ruples? Look, there's alligators.
Hip. Where are those alligators?
They're right there. They're by the things.
Nice.
Whoa.
I don't know what's going on with my camera right now.
It's dancing.
It's freaking out.
What is happening?
I don't know.
It's got that, what's it? Oh, shoot. The alligator jiggling fever.
Yeah. It's crocodile jiggling fever or something.
I guess
he's got
just
some
that
sort of
room.
Jiggling fever.
Yeah, it's got a jiggling fever.
He's got a fever and he needs to go see a doctor. That's all we know.
That's all anyone knows anymore.
Let me in. Knock, knock.
Now, where are we? Oh. This room has always made me die a lot before I realized I was an idiot. I'll see if you could figure it out, because I never can.
Because you never can?
Yeah, I'm just a dum-dum.
Come on down. Oh. What? What do we got going on here? What's ZR? That's ZR.
That's, yeah.
Okay, that does nothing. This can move somehow.
I'll tell you this so you don't waste any hearts. You cannot jump to any of those little rock pillars over
there.
Oh,
I know. I can tell that I can't jump to any of them. Bum, 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 bum. Okay.
So I found out something today.
Did you?
Apparently, Samsung makes a phone called the Samsung Galaxy J7.
Is it the Japanese 7?
No, it's at least not that it looked like to me when I was looking it up. But my principal, my boss, apparently bought that phone for his mother. And she's too old and can't figure out how to use it, so he's selling it. But it looks like it's pretty much a lower quality S7. But it's like they have apparently a whole J series. Hey, you did it.
Figured it out.
That's about as long as it takes me.
I should have just done the thing that I do on every wall.
Yeah.
Just roll into it.
Use your head. Ready to get some alligator jiggling fever? I hate these alligators.
Whoa. Okay.
You got killed.
Yeah. Sure did.
Yeah. I'd recommend trying to use the bow on the alligator's tails. Man, that guy cannot figure out where you are. It's like, where the hell is he? Uh-oh.
His flame doesn't reach me, so.
No, it didn't. I thought for sure it would.
Oh, okay. All right, that one went right through it.
Yeah. His tail can only be hit at certain angles.
Oh. Okay. I thought they were one more over.
I just thought you saw them all. I didn't realize you were going to do that
them.
That fast.
I just didn't know that,
Well, at least the alligators are dead right now.
For now. Alright.
The only reason I keep mentioning the alligator jiggling fever is that, apparently there's some, like, hamburger-making game. And, it's somebody who's a fan of the Grumps made the game. And, they put the Grumps in there as customers, and also somebody said something about wanting alligator jiggling fever.
Oh, damn it. I thought I could get up there to kill him when they dropped.
I don't think there's enough room up there.
I only have 11
so I keep thinking
arrows.
About alligator jiggling fever.
Oh. Oh,
it's just wow, really fun to say. What?
Hoping for more arrows. There's an alligator on the ceiling over there.
Yep, there's an alligator on the ceiling. Man, somebody just dropped arrows into the lava. Stupid slugs. I wouldn't kill those ones because they might drop arrows and we can grab them after we get over there. Because those guys, they can, if we go slow enough, they'll just fall right in front of us and you could just poke them. Stick them with the pointy end.
I didn't know if I was going to be landing next to them like the other ones.
No.
Oh, okay. A Rupal. More Rupal. Do the alligators drop?
No, the alligator won't drop. We have to go up there and kill it. No. Whee!
It's so violent that how he gets pulled up, too.
Yeah. Like his legs get ripped out from underneath him.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, I gave it to you.
Heart. And then I probably gotta shoot this, don't I?
Yep.
Where am I?
Isn't being on the ceiling fun?
No. Sucks. Probably didn't even need to kill the alligator.
I think you did.
Seems like he was farther away. Like I might have been able to get away with it, you know?
I think he kind of like patrols around. He might have walked right up to you as you were trying to aim at the little jewel.
Yeah, maybe.
Chest.
All right, so I think that we should end the episode here and then tackle these cranes and stuff.
Too much tummy poking this time.
Too much tummy poking. In fact, if I do end up cutting that stuff out, it may be a little bit of a shorter episode. But that's fine. Look at that, 50 rubles. You saw me get that.
End this on a high note.
Yeah, alive and with arrows.
Yep.
That's a high note for me. All right, guys, we'll see you for the next one. If you like this episode, make sure to give it a thumbs up. I do appreciate it. I'm terribly, terribly sorry that I'm terribly terrible at killing bosses in this game, but it's the second dungeon?
Yeah, we're only on the second. We're not done yet.
Yeah, so I'll get better, I'm sure.
No.
No, I won't.
If you're doing this bad already.
Yeah, on the easy ones.
Yeah.
Yeah.